Hello, my dear students. In this lecture, we are going to see one numerical on convection to find convective heat transfer coefficient H. So let us understand the question. The question is: atmospheric air flows inside a heated thin walled 25 mm diameter tube. Now here air is flowing through a tube or diameter tube, means it is a cylinder. Let us say there is a cylinder like this. Let us say this is a cylinder. Through this cylinder, the air is flowing. Therefore, inside, I can say there will be an air. Through this tube, which is flowing. Right. Let us say the diameter of tube is given. Here, the diameter will be D. And length will be L. And diameter will be D. Here, diameter is given 25 mm. This is nothing but 25 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter, right? Then an air is flowing through this with a velocity of 0.5 meter per second. This air is flowing with a velocity of, now the velocity of flow is given 0.5 meter per second. Then heating can be done either by condensing steam on the outer surface of the tube, thus maintaining a uniform surface temperature. Now my dear students, for this wall, the heating can be done by condensing steam. Now here, to outside this tube, there is a steam. Here outside this tube, there is a steam. And this steam may get condensed to get this tube heated. Right? And thus, they have mentioned, thus maintaining the uniform surface temperature. Means the first type of heating is uniform surface temperature. Uniform surface temperature. That is constant surface temperature. That is wall temperature. Wall temperature will be constant. This is the first type of heating. Let us say the tube wall temperature is T wall. Tube wall temperature is T wall, right, which is constant. This is the first type of heating. Our second type of heating is, or by electric resistance heating, thus maintaining a uniform surface heat flux. Now second type of heating is, around this tube, the coils are wound, and because of this coil, we are heating this tube such that it maintains a uniform surface heat flux. Means second type of heating is for uniform heat flux. Uniform heat flux, which is nothing but here heat flux Q will be constant, which is watt per meter square, is constant. This heat flux will be constant. These are the two different types of heatings, right? Now calculate the heat transfer coefficient for both these cases. Now here for uniform surface temperature as well as for uniform heat flux, calculate convective heat transfer coefficient EH. We have to calculate EH, will be question mark. EH will be question mark, right? For both these heating conditions, assume air properties of 350 Kelvin given as, now the air temperature is 350 Kelvin, means surrounding fluid temperature. T infinity is given, 350 Kelvin, and the air properties are given. Here kinematic viscosity, meter square per second is nothing but unit of kinematic viscosity, right? So here kinematic viscosity is given 20, here it is a kinematic viscosity nu is equal to 20.76 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square per second, which is nothing but dynamic viscosity divided by mass density, right? Then thermal conductivity is given, K is equal to 0.03 watt per meter Kelvin. Therefore thermal conductivity of air is given 0.03 watt per meter Kelvin, right? And the flow as hydrodynamically and thermally developed. Now here the flow is hydrodynamically as well as thermally developed, right? Now my dear students, first of all, for such type of flow, let us calculate Reynolds number. Now Reynolds number is nothing but, for flow through pipe, the Reynolds number is rho v d upon mu, where rho is density, v is velocity, d is diameter of pipe, and mu is here dynamic viscosity. Therefore it will become Vd divided by mu by rho, because diameter of pipe is, we have written small d, mu by rho. This mu by rho is nothing but kinematic viscosity. Therefore it will become Vd divided by kinematic viscosity. Therefore this Reynolds number for this pipe will be equal to, velocity is 0.5, it is given, diameter is given 25 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 25 into 10 to the power minus 3. You have a kinematic viscosity. Kinematic viscosity is given 20.67 into 10 to the power minus 6 over here, right? So let us calculate this Reynolds number. I will get this Reynolds number is equal to 602, right? So my dear students, this Reynolds number is equal to 602. Can I say this is less than 2000? As it is a flow through pipe, for flow through pipe, when your Reynolds number is less than 2000, it is called laminar flow. It is called laminar flow, right? Therefore, here the flow is laminar. Now, first, for laminar with constant surface temperature, we have to calculate convective heat transfer coefficient TH. And second, for laminar with uniform heat flux, we have to calculate convective heat transfer coefficient TH. So let us solve this question. Now, very first is for laminar and fully developed, here they have mentioned hydrodynamically and thermally developed. For laminar, fully developed with constant wall temperature, with constant wall temperature. For this condition, the Nusselt number is constant, and the value of Nusselt number, this value you must remember, very very important for competitive exams. For laminar flow through pipe, for fully developed flow with constant wall temperature, the Nusselt number is 3.66, and this Nusselt number is nothing but Nusselt number is HL. Here the formula is HL divided by K. HL divided by K, where this L is diameter, right? L is characteristic dimension, and for flow through pipe it is a diameter. Therefore, instead of L, I will write here diameter. Otherwise, you will get confused, right? It is HD divided by K. This characteristic dimension, and for flow through pipe the characteristic dimension is diameter, right? Therefore, here this Nusselt number is 3.66 is equal to EH into diameter is 25 into 10 to the power minus 3. There are thermal conductivity is 0.03, right? Now in this equation only EH is unknown. Let us simplify this equation for EH. You will get 4.39 watt per meter square Kelvin. This will be the value of convective heat transfer coefficient EH for laminar flow with fully developed with constant wall temperature, right? Now let us solve for uniform heat flux. Now second is for uniform heat flux, that is laminar, for laminar flow through pipe with fully developed and uniform heat flux, and uniform heat flux. For this case, the Nusselt number, which is constant, is nothing but 4.364. This value you must remember. For laminar flow through pipe with a fully developed flow and with uniform heat flux, the Nusselt number is 4.364, and this Nusselt number is nothing but HD divided by K. So let us put the values. Therefore, 4.364 is equal to H for uniform heat flux into diameter is 25 into 10 to the power minus 3. Here our thermal conductivity is here 0.03. Therefore, from this I will get H is equal to, let us find, I will get 5.24 watt per meter square Kelvin. Thank you, dear students. In next lecture, we will see one more numerical on this topic.